3-year-old trotters going post-grid. And now it is time for the call to the post for the 78th Hamiltonian. Here's the field, number one, Power to Charm.
He's versatile, doesn't appear to need a trip, and has been first or second in all but one race this year in six starts.
Of John Campbell's five Hamiltonian wins, four of the horses he has driven to victory have been favored. The sport's all-time leading money winner drives his fifth Hambo favorite today. And from the back paddock, the 1A, Muscle King.
He'll be outside in post eight, a $9,500 yearling purchase, speedy from the first prop of Muscle's Yankee, the 1998 Hamiltonian winner.
The youngest driver in the race at age 35, Brian Sears, is making his Hamiltonian debut in his first season at the Meadowlands. Number two is Bebop.
He won the third elimination by 4.5 lengths, and Jimmy Tactor, winner of the Oaks earlier today.
And Jimmy Tactor, the only trainer to drive his horse in this year's Hamiltonian. It's his 11th appearance overall in the Hambo. Number three, we'll see in a moment. There's Penn Pronto.
We'll be in post two. Connections are happy just to be here. The colt is lightly raced. He's gone from relative obscurity, raced barefoot without shoes to help him with hoof problems, and he'll do it again today.
New Jersey native Jack Moiseev is competing in his fifth Hamiltonian final. 43-year-old won this race in 1991 with Giant Victory. Next up will be the four Malabar Millennium.
The son of Malabar Man came home in 27-4 in the Stanley Dancer, well behind Power to Charm. He picked the right time to break his maiden, though, in the eliminations.
And this is David Miller's Hamiltonian final driving debut, having competed in seven eliminations previously. Ohio native, currently the leading money-winning driver in North America. And from the back paddock, number five, Sugar Trader.
Here's our Jekyll and Hyde, who's been plagued by some hoof problems. He is a home track favorite, was second to Malabar Millennium in the Elims, and in the Stanley Dancer, hit his hock on the bike, but seems to have trained very well since then.
And he is second choice at 9-2, 38-year-old Luke Millette's best Hambo finish was in 1999, a third from Troy Levesque. And we're going to see number six, Amigo Hall.
Son of Balanced Image kicked off the season with back-to-back wins at Woodbine. He's hit the board in all six starts this year.
Hall of Famer Michael Chad starts right next to his nephew, Luke Ouellette, in today's Hambo final. 52-year-old having one of his best seasons ever, going for his fourth Hamiltonian. Number seven, Smooth Glide.
He was third in the eliminations to Power to Charm, beaten 3.5 lengths, but came home the best last quarter of anyone in the field.
Driver Jim Morrill Jr. has plied his trade successfully on many of harness racing circuits. His only other drive in a Hamiltonian final, 1998, finished 10th with Armbrough Rotary, who made a break. Number eight, we'll see, Max Crown K.
Most experienced in the field with 30 starts lifetime. He's won six of them and is a homebred for Bob Key.
Driver Ron Pierce won this race exactly 10 years ago with another Bob Key owned and bred trotter, American winner. He was also second last year with Like a Prayer, and he won the Hamiltonian Oaks earlier today. This could be a huge day for Pierce. And finally, coming out from the back paddock, number nine, Incredible Hulk.
He'll break on the outside in post 10, son of Muscles Yankees, 4-17 lifetime. His only win this year was in the Reynolds Stakes at Pocono.
Driver George Brennan making his second Hamiltonian final start. You know, both have been for trainer Chuck Sylvester, the other being a ninth place finish in 1998 with Sylvester's Silver Pine. That's a look at the field for the 2003 Hamiltonian. The entry now, and that's pretty much what I was thinking, Caton. 3-5 on that. Bebop, still a good price at 5-1. And Sugar Trader is getting a lot of attention. 8-1 morning line, 9-2. It's straight ahead, the 78th edition of the Hamiltonian here on CBS. Right now, let's go up to the voice of the Meadowlands and the Hamiltonian. Here's track announcer Ken Workington with the call.
They're on the way in the 2003 $1 million Hamiltonian, making a break there with Smooth Glide far back at the start. Here they come, an off-stride Bebop. Bebop is off stride, a costly error early there, and Amigo Hall guns out. An Incredible Hulk from the outside tried to leave, and he is off stride. So early breakers here. Penn Pronto squeezed through on the inside as Malabar Millennium moves up second. It's Amigo Hall, Mike LaChance by two lengths there. Around the first turn, Malabar Millennium second. The favorite, Power to Charm, got away well in good order third. Sugar Trader is fourth. Max Crown K is close up in fifth. A wide gap to Incredible Hulk after his break. And on a break, Smooth Glide once again. Penn Pronto way back, who made a break, and Bebop is out of it after his break in stride. First quarter was slow, 28-2. Mike LaChance will try to steal it here with Amigo Hall. But here comes John Campbell with Power to Charm, looking to make a key move to the top here. Power to Charm now engages Amigo Hall up the backstretch and takes over. Malabar Millennium close up in third, gap of four lengths. Sugar Trader is fourth past the half. Max Crown K appears trying to tip out with that one. Then comes Incredible Hulk, way back to Penn Pronto, Bebop, and the distant trailer, Smooth Glide. The half was 55-4, 27-2. They picked it up there, and it's Power to Charm. John Campbell by a length and a half. Amigo Hall right there in the tight second as they approach three quarters. Charging hard, here comes Sugar Trader on the outside. As Sugar Trader and Luke Willett lock up, Power to Charm on the inside. And John Campbell steps on the gas there under the pressure of Sugar Trader. Looming large, Max Crown K. Pierce tips three wide with that one. Amigo Hall looks for room. Then it's Incredible Hulk. Three quarters, 125. A good rated quarter there. Power to Charm. Sugar Trader on the outside is powering to the lead. It's Sugar Trader, but Max Crown K stalked him all the way. Pierce going to work there. Incredible K on the outside. And shaking loose late on the inside. Amigo Hall is coming. It's Amigo Hall. Iron Mike LaChance pulls off the shocker at 27-1. It's Amigo Hall. He takes it here over Sugar Trader. Third was Max Crown K. 154. Mike LaChance, what a season he's having. Mike LaChance scores here with Amigo Hall in a shocking victory in the Hamiltonian.
It is Amigo Hall and a shocking upset here, except for maybe track announcer Ken Workington, who liked Amigo Hall. 27-1, Mike LaChance wins the Hamiltonian for the fourth time, and this time he does it for a different trainer, because all three previous wins had in fact been for trainer Ron Gurfein. This one coming for Blair Burgess, who is having an incredible year. Caitlin, let's take another look down the stretch.
Well, costly breaks early changed the complexion of this race completely and forced John Campbell's hand a little bit with Power to Charge. He raced up on the backstretch to take the lead, and then under pressure from a bold moving Amigo Hall and others down the stretch, just kind of collapses. A couple of huge performances, including Max Crown K, who made a couple of charges at the leader, but never could quite get there, and in the end settles for third behind Amigo Hall, but a brilliant drive from Mike LaChance.
So it is Amigo Hall winning the Hamiltonian. Right now, let's talk to Hall of Famer Mike LaChance. And Mike, it looks like you saved all the possible ground you could. Obviously, you weren't expecting all those breakers, but it certainly must have worked in your favor.
Definitely. I wasn't going to leave the gate at all, but when I saw behind the gate, my horse was so good. When I scored him down, and he was like right on the gate and sharp, and just let him out of there, and the rest is history. I couldn't go on with John, because, you know, I figured he was the best horse in the race, and I just got lucky that I could get out at the end.
Mike, you are now part of Hamiltonian history one more time. Congratulations. Thanks very much. Hopefully we'll get a chance to talk to you later on when we get up here for these ceremonies and festivities. In the meantime, let's take another look down the stretch here. And Kate and Amigo Hall was definitely equal to the task today. It is Amigo Hall. Blair Burgess, trainer, wins it in his Hamiltonian debut. We'll have the results after this. Amigo Hall, and right now I'm standing by with his trainer, Blair Burgess. You know, you started out your career in harness racing, training claimers, cheaper claimers, and now you're one of the top developers of young talent in the game. You had 2002 Horse of the Year, Real Desire. You are on a roll.
It is, for sure. I'm not usually good with the trotters, but this is a little bit different, and it's a lot of fun. Do you want me to say? And the horse has been a pleasant surprise. I mean, he's a great two-year-old, but speed-wise, but he never really showed it till now, and came around on the right day.
Let's take a look at the start here. I think the start was extremely important because of the fact that there were several breakers in here, and that certainly had to help your chances.
Very important. I think Bebop, you know, I don't like to capitalize on other people's problems, but Bebop making a mistake helped us. I think that's why Mike decided to leave early for position. And when you get a good position, it's a speed track today, I think, and you got a good position along the rail, and I think that helped us later on in the mile.
And was it a surprise to you that he went to the lead?
No, the horse has good gate speed. I told Mike he could use it if he wanted to. He had to decide at the last minute.
We're taking a look, and Mike picking up his fourth Hambletonian victory. Coming down the lane here, were you a little surprised that Power to Charm didn't have it today, and Sugar Trader also flattened out somewhat?
I thought it was a very even field. Come down to trip, and if my horse was right, I thought he had a good chance.
Well, your Hambletonian debut, and that's the way to go out of it as a winner.
It is that for sure.
All right, Blair Burgess, winning trainer of Amigo Hall. Right now, let's go down to Caton Bradar for the trophy presentation. Caton?
I'm surrounded by winners, Gary Tom Charters of the Hambletonian Society, George Zoffinger of the Sports Authority, our gracious hosts today, and of course the winners, we have Alan Levitt back there, Bob Burgess, and the rest of the family, and I think Alan's going to be the spokesman, but George, you can do the honors. It's been a terrific day.
Well, Alan and Bob, Amigo Hall ran a great race. Welcome to New Jersey, and here's the Hambletonian Trophy. Congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you so much. I've been in horse racing for 46 years, and this is the greatest thrill I've ever had. And the Burgesses and I have known each other and had horses together for 37 years, so I guess perseverance pays.
Alan, you said a little earlier you felt a little guilty being the spokesperson. Why?
Well, I've been we bred the colt and raised him, put him through the sale, and he fell $1,000 short of the reserve. So we wound up selling half of him to the Burgesses, thank God. And I felt guilty because the Burgesses really, they're responsible for him. Blair made him and trained him, got him ready for this race, and they got the drivers, they've done everything to him. And now I feel guilty. I'm holding the best trophy that we have in harness racing, maybe in all of racing as far as I'm concerned.
Well, don't feel guilty. Enjoy the moment. It's well earned.
Thank you very much.
Congratulations. Gary?
All right, Caton, thanks so much. There is a look at the winner, Amigo Hall, bred by Walnut Hall, which now ties them with Hanover Shoe Farms. 9 victories, breeders with the most Hambletonian wins. Amigo Hall wins this year's edition of the Hambletonian. An excellent effort, but a surprise to most, except to track announcer Ken Workington. Big day here at the Hambletonian, wrapping up not only the season,